Hey, what's up guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, I'll be giving you a small tip in Laravel with which you can improve the performance of your application drastically. So without any further ado, let's get into it. As you can see here in the dashboard controller, I have these articles here. So I have fetched all the articles and I have seeded 1000 articles in the database. So if you see here in the database, I have this articles table and I have these fields over here. And if I show you the data over here, so you can see here there are a lot of data that I have seeded here, yeah. So these titles logs are normal strings and these short description and descriptions are the long text. So we have so many data here. So in any article you can see a long description there, yeah. So it's a real world example. And in the dashboard controller I have just fetched the articles, all the articles, and I have just returned it in the dashboard. Normally in a news or any article website, you will be fetching a lot of articles and then you will group them together and show them separately in the home page. That basically happens. So we are getting all the articles here for now. Okay, so now if I go here in the dashboard controller, so I am just commenting out this my previous tutorial codes, okay, and this is the current one. So I have just looped through the articles and I have shown articles title and the published at date. Okay, so I have done only this, but in a real case, so you would just group these articles by category. You will have the category or tags in the articles and you will group them together here and you will return to the view and you will show that in the real world scenario. Basically you will fetch all the articles in the initial phase and there also comes some cachings and something like that, but currently we are not doing any caching here. Okay, so inside the dashboard just we are looping and showing them, and in the browser you can see here in the dashboard, so we are just showing this title and this published at date. Now if I refresh here, if you see it carefully, if I refresh it over here and at the bottom of this page, so you can see here it is using 19 MB of RAM. It is a lot of RAM. This is using a lot of RAM. Okay, so here are a lot of data, so that's why it is using a lot of RAM. But by doing some small tricks, we can drastically reduce the RAM usage. So you can see here we are only showing here this title and the published at date, and here in the controller we are getting all the data from the article. So look here in the articles here, so we are getting all titles, log, image, short description, description, published at, created at, updated at, every column data we are getting here. So we don't want all those data here, yeah. So we are only showing here the title and the published at, so we will be only getting that. So if you look here in the query as well, so in the browser here, this is the debug bar. I'll leave the link of this debug bar package in the description below, just below that like button. So here in the query you can see here select all from articles, so it is taking 25.8 milliseconds and it is also consuming a lot of RAM over here. So now let us only select those columns that we want. So if you see here closely, so 19 MB of RAM, yeah. So now here in the code, so if we say select and we only want title and published at, now if we come here in the browser and refresh the page, now you can see here the consumption of RAM has been drastically reduced to 7 MB and the time for the execution of this query has also been reduced to 2.99 milliseconds. So before it was, I think it was around 20 to 25, yeah. So now that has also been drastically reduced and the RAM has also been drastically reduced. So guys, in a very big project or very big data, if you don't want any data to be visible to the user, then don't fetch it from the database. So if you fetch it from the database, then it will take a lot of memory. Normally those columns that have very huge amount of data in them, it will take a lot of RAM, and if your app is being used by a lot of users, then it will be very very slow. So after watching this video, if your application is running slowly, then you can go ahead and remove those columns that you don't want to be visible in the user end or in the front end. Just do that and check if your application becomes a little bit faster. So I hope you enjoyed this video guys. If you enjoyed this video, then please don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and also hit subscribe button if you want to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye.